I'm not a two-stepping man. I said I do not dance. It's a gun inside my pants, and the whole world's in his hands.
The main objective of the laboratory is to obtain the fingerprint impression from the evidence that the criminal investigator acquired from the crime scene, and to analyze the fingerprint impression by the use of three methods: dusting, nail spoor, and blood alone. To obtain facts and solve the crime by the use of analyzed patterns and ridges of the fingerprint impressions left by the perpetrator.
For all laboratory proper, we must see to it that we should comply from major proper attire in obtaining fingerprint marks. The laboratory gown, the face mask, and the gloves must be worn to avoid contamination and alteration of the evidence.
After dislodging the charcoal powder, gently brush the excess powder from the item, appear the fingerprint. This is the fingerprint mark. And by the use of lifting tape, this is the lifting tape. Gently place it to the surface and make sure the tape covered the visible fingerprint mark. So, i-cover natin yung fingerprint mark. After this, place it to the fingerprint impression to the fingerprint card. Ipi-place natin yung fingerprint mark dito sa fingerprint mark. Ay, fingerprint card. This is we obtain in the item from the crime scene.
Place this body of a crime in a clean and dry safe container in order to prevent contamination and alteration of the obtained evidence.
With this process, we obtain the first evidence may use for the conviction of the suspect.
In addition, we use black powder as we apply the principle of contrast in order to obtain and to see fingerprint impression by the naked eye.
After mixing this mixture, we're going to place the evidence on a flat surface and we're going to look for the fingerprint impression. And with this mixture, we will apply this on the evidence obtained from the crime scene. After applying it, set aside for a couple of minutes to dry it off. After that, we're going to wash it gently on a running water to remove the excess of the powder. After drying it off, directly wash on a running water to remove the excess powder. We should prevent the running water on the fingerprint. And as you can see, there's a fingerprint right here. And this will be the fingerprint impression that will be used. After this, dry it, and we're going to lift the fingerprint impression by the lifting tape. After drying it off, we're going to use the lifting tape in order to obtain the fingerprint impression. This is the fingerprint impression that we got. And
the last method is using by blood alone. This procedure is the easiest course of obtaining a fingerprint impression from this item. It is easy from other procedure since we will not need a powder to visibly and obtaining a finger mark, but the blood alone will provide its own imprint. So here's the item needed for this procedure: lifting tape, fingerprint card, and the evidence alone.
For the process, gently place the knife on the flat surface. Second is the gently the lifting tape on the surface on the knife. In order to obtain the fingerprint and place it on finger card. The lifted fingerprint mark on fingerprint shall safely place it on a container. And this is a container to secure the fingerprint card. Make sure it is dry, clear, and clean to avoid contamination by the perpetrator. This body of crime may use further comparison and conviction of the perpetrator.
As I analyze and study the ridges and the pattern of this obtained fingerprint impression from the fingerprint card, I therefore conclude that the fingerprints are all the same, and each belong to Mr. Pedro Fernando, as the fees result are 100% the same.